Do you regret going to Tokyo and racing in the Olympic triathlon?
I do. I really regret racing. Looking back now, 6 months later, I wish I didn't start. It wasn't worth it. At the time, I thought, you know, go all in. But the consequences that I have to live with right now is far beyond just saying that I went to the Olympics. But at that time, you know, I was like so motivated and driven and in the mindset that I was going to win a gold medal. So how do you tell an athlete who's ready to win a gold medal, don't go race?
What has the last 6 months been medical-wise?
The last 6 months, in terms of medical, has been 8 MRIs, 3 CT scans, 4 ultrasound scans, countless doctor visits, 4 specialized orthopedic surgeon consultations, one from overseas in the Netherlands, 2 of them professors, changing nutrition, changing diet, like, what more can I say?
Morning.
Hey, how cool is this?
It's nice. How do you feel about going for surgery?
I'm pretty nervous. I'm scared about the surgery because you're kind of like leaving everything in the hands of the surgeon. And what's daunting to me is that like you get put out and there's nothing you can do about it and you wake up and then something's going to be different. And in this case, my foot is going to be different. So I'm just praying and hoping that it's going to be a successful surgery. It seems straightforward. So I'm nervous about that part, and of course I'm sure anyone would be. The plan for the surgery is to compress the fracture. Because it's becoming an early non-union, meaning the bone's not healing, and we're already 6 months down the line, we need to kind of intervene with something, and we're doing a screw fixation. So he's going to put 3 more pins in, 2 or 3 of them, compress the fracture, hopefully drain one of the cysts, and then
And are you excited for the challenge that the comeback is going to offer?
Oh yeah, like I'm super excited for the comeback. I've been excited since day one after Tokyo for the comeback, but it's been a long journey. But we're here now, we're taking the next step that's necessary. And yeah, I'm just super pumped and excited to get back to training and back to racing.
Brought a little good luck charm with. What happened in the build up?
The build up went really well and I was happy with where I was until 3 weeks before Tokyo. Suddenly I couldn't run. I couldn't run at all because the pain was too bad. I had some knee issues, so I was compensating quite a bit, and then I started feeling like a bit of pain on my right ankle, but I didn't think too much of it because I've had this kind of pain before and I thought I'd just work it through. The MRI scans before Tokyo showed that there was bone bruising in the talus, but no signs of stress fracture or anything like that. We just thought it was inflammation in the ankle joint and sinus tarsi.
Where were we off to?
We're walking to the hospital. It's probably about 800 meters. So, nice walk of freedom.
Making your pregnant wife exercise.
800 meters, you walk more than ever.
Feels like 10 kilometers late. We are. I'm reward. Yes, son.
I'm here at the Intercare Medical Center at Century City. Today is surgery day. I'm nervous, but I'm also excited to just get back to doing what I love doing, and that's triathlon, training, racing, and just being back to normal. So yeah, it's come to this point, and holding thumbs and praying that it will be a successful surgery. Okay, it's almost time to go in. Let's do this.
Her dad must be ready.
And we're out.
We out.
Successful surgery. Whew. Glad that's over.
Now time for cake and tea.
100%.
Excuse me.
Straight out of hospital.
You've lost your mind. Yes, sis.
Days post-surgery, it's gone pretty well. The first 7 days was quite tricky. I mean, I didn't feel great after the anesthetics and with a lot of the pain meds. I felt very drowsy, very tired. I didn't feel like doing much. I felt sick a lot of the times. Between 7 and 10 days post-op, it's been going really well. I've been feeling more alive. I've been feeling more myself. I've been doing some walks down to the lagoon here. In harmonious, but I was still able to get in a few exercises, just keep the muscles a little bit active. And yeah, also been upping my exercise routine. So, you know, in the mornings I like to do a ab HIIT workout. I just focus on core strength, keeping the glutes nice and strong. And it's a little bit of cardio, but it's not much. But I mean, at least I get to work a good sweat, and it's a good hour where I'm keeping the upper legs as strong as I can, the glutes as strong as they can, the back muscles, just so that everything is still nice and strong, so that when I start putting weight on my foot, it's not like a completely new thing, the muscles are still mostly there. In between, I've been doing a lot of muscle activation with EMS. It's been pretty good. I think I'm quite happy with the 10 days that I've done. The cast is coming off soon, so I'm excited to see what the whole ankle looks like post-surgery. If there's still swelling, if hopefully there's no infection, hopefully I'll be able to do a little bit of mobility with my ankle, because I think it will be quite stiff. And then try to get that EMS stimulation through my calves to get that muscle stimulation again and get it firing and active and working. So, you know, this is going to be important in the build up to running again.
Do you want me to get you peeing as well?